Hi there, Doug Stuman with IT Creations with another Gigabyte server, the 1U Gigabyte R183-Z96 Rack server. This is a general purpose server for networking, which includes uses as a virtual server, file storage, a shared internet connection, or file access via VPN. Also good for a hybrid private cloud server, which includes applications like web hosting, databases, and ecommerce. It does still deliver on performance with support for AMD EPYC 9004 series processors, SATA NVMe storage, and a PCIe 5.0 expansion interface. Hit that subscribe button if you like our channel, or that stupid bell thing. Let's get to it. There are two versions of this system, the AAV1 with Titanium PSUs and the AAD1 with Platinum PSUs. That's the only difference. Aside from that, same. This is a 1U server, but still supports up to 6 terabytes of memory with dual processors. Storage is somewhat limited with 4 3.5-inch drive bays, but you also get 4 2.5-inch drive bays. Looks like you might get away with installing 2 GPUs on this system too. The front panel has support for SAS, SATA, and NVMe drive types in both a 3.5-inch and 2.5-inch bays. Those 2.5-inch bays are limited to a 9.5mm drive thickness, whereas the standard thickness for an enterprise-grade 2.5-inch drive is 15mm. That'd be for storage, servers, and enterprise environments, or 7mm for PCs, notebooks, and even for hyperscale enterprise environments, just to give you an idea of the various sizes and uses in general. Those 3.5-inch drive bays can also support 2.5-inch drives, and this system is outfitted with two 2.5-inch U.3 NVMe drives with reads of up to 14,000 megabytes per second and writes of 3,000 megabytes per second. It uses a PCIe 5.0 x8 bus. Those drives are 15mm thick, so a no-go in the 2.5-inch bays. It's a super fast drive for reads. The front control panel offers a USB port, USB 3.2 Gen 1 port, non-maskable interrupt NMI button, a reset button, an ID button with LED, power on button with LED, and a few telltale LEDs for LAN activity, HDD activity, and system status. Are you interested in adopting this 1U Gigabyte R183-Z96 rack server? Cute and cuddly without the shedding? If you are, then for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off a system that's listed or one that you can configure at IT Creations that's valued at $5,000 or more. Just click that link for more information, and when you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video. Simple. Given we have the AAD1 version of this system, on the back of the chassis there are dual redundant 1600 watt Platinum PSUs to either side. In between are two OCP 3.0 card slots, again to either side. One of those OCP 3.0 mezzanine card slots is outfitted with a quad port card featuring 25 gigabit per second SFP 28 Ethernet and a PCIe 4.0x16 interface. The PCIe 5.0x16 mezzanine slot is backwards compatible to support the PCIe 4.0 card. The OCP 3.0 cards are easy to remove and install by removing the screws to either side on the back of the chassis and sliding the card in. No need to remove the cover. In between those, the I/O panel with mini display port, ID LED, two USB 3.2 Gen 1 ports, two 1 gigabit Ethernet ports with dedicated server management LAN port beside, two PCIe ports above. The MLAN port on the back of the system provides access to the integrated ASSPEED AST2600 baseboard management controller. This platform also offers dual read-only memory architecture that stores the BMC and BIOS. If it fails to boot, the backup ROM will boot the system. Pretty slick. Remote management on this powerful little 1U system is offered by the Gigabyte Management Console. It's a free-of-charge management application enabling real-time management and health monitoring through a standard browser-based graphical interface. That would be for a single server or small cluster. It can also integrate with the installed Broadcom MegaRAID controller. For more robust management, there's GSM or the Gigabyte Server Management. Once the GSM agent is installed on each server to be managed, it leverages the pre-installed management console to enable administrators to manage clusters of servers simultaneously over the internet. It complies with Redfish and IPMI standards, and there's a GSM plugin to integrate with VMware vCenter. There are a few more utilities to make life more simple, including a mobile app. Once we remove a few screws and crawl inside the case, you can see the basic layout with 8 miniature fans in front blowing fresh air through the plastic fan ducts and over the processors. Offering Zen 4 architecture and AMD 9004 series processors, or 9004 series processors with 3D V-cache technology, those can be installed. 3D V-cache processors offer more L3 cache and better performance in general. With 4th generation AMD 3D V-cache technology, the L3 cache went from 768 megabytes with third gen EPYCs to 1152 megabytes with the top end of the three CPUs in that 3D V-cache category, the 9684X. They all end with an X suffix. Still only 96 cores out of a potential of 128 cores when compared to the standard AMD EPYC 9004 series CPUs. This system has a configurable TDP of 300 watts with support for 400 watt CPUs under certain thermal conditions, as noted. Our system is set up with two AMD EPYC 9274F Gen 4 CPUs offering 24 physical cores and 48 virtual threads. Those are paired with four registered 64GB DDR4 memory modules operating at a frequency of 4800 MHz for up to 256 GB of memory. At full capacity and using 3DS memory modules in all 24 slots, this system can support up to 6 terabytes of memory, but only up to about 2 terabytes using registered DIMMs, like on this system. With 12 memory channels per CPU, each memory module will operate in its very own memory channel for optimal performance. If outfitted with the 128-core 9754 CPUs, we could have up to 256 cores and 512 virtual threads with both CPUs installed. Also on the system board are three PCIe Gen 3 slots, two of which have a x4 interface, with the last a x2 interface. All three are for NVMe M.2 drives. You can link two of those drives in a RAID 1 to support the OS in mirror mode. For control of the upfront storage, there is a Broadcom MegaRAID 9670W-16i tri-mode controller. It offers a full range of RAID possibilities. With this controller, there is definitely the potential for installing more storage with support for 240 SAS SATA devices or 32 NVMe devices per controller. Of course, we only have 8 storage bays on the system. If you were to add SAS drives, a storage controller is required. Two full-height, full-length PCIe 5.0x16 slots are supported in the risers. Those slots can be outfitted with additional NICs to augment what is already installed in the OCP slot and the built-in Gigabyte Ethernet. Those could also be used to support a hardware controller like we have on this system, or perhaps two small GPUs like the NVIDIA T4 or A2, as there are a few power connectors on the system board should the slot not provide the juice. Featuring dual AMD EPYC 9004 series CPUs, the Gigabyte R183-Z96 certainly delivers some impressive attributes for a number of standard networking and even private hybrid cloud applications. It's highly configurable with support for SAS, SATA, NVMe storage, and up to 6 terabytes of memory. At only 1U, if you need some computing power paired with super fast storage, this might be it. If you want to learn more, click that link right there or the one in the description. Need something a little more robust? Check out IT Creations. We're partners with Gigabyte and many other manufacturers, and we offer custom configuration. ITCreations.com. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations, and thanks for watching.